Hi, I'm Jon Sturgård, Finnish conductor. I'm here first time conducting the Bern Symphony Orchestra with a very nice program, and I'm very happy to have the possibility to do this within these demanding times. My first impression of the town, as I remember it from when I was very young here with the student orchestra, that it's a very beautiful place. And with the first thing when I got to the hotel yesterday and watched out from my window, I thought that, oh, this is like a paradise view. So, very nice first impression, but really I didn't have much time to look around yet, but now I will. The big idea with this program is that everything has something to do with birds. That's the main idea. Also in the Dvořák Symphony, which of course is the famous piece in this program, there is a kind of bird call theme involved in that symphony. At some point I came up with this idea of why not to build up the whole program around nature and especially around bird sounds of different kinds. Personally, I really like the Nielsen piece by the Danish composer Carl Nielsen, little piece that people usually don't know at all. It's a fantasy trip to the Faroe Islands, and that's also very much about the imagination of how you get closer and closer to the Faroe Islands, which is a very special place, with a ship, and then the first things you hear from the island is just nature and birds, wild birds, and then you get closer and then you hear other things, then there's a lot of other things going on, but also at the very end of the piece, the last things you hear is also something in the nature. Then Catherine Bryan, who is a good friend of mine and a great flute player, she plays first time ever for her by a Finnish composer, Erik Bergman, Birds in the Morning. And then we go into the Vaughan Williams Lark Ascending, which especially in Britain is a huge hit piece that everybody knows, which usually is always played with solo violin and orchestra. But Catherine has made her own arrangement of that piece for flute solo. And then comes the break and the Dvořák Symphony, which is one of his most happy pieces, really. And I think that's exactly what we need these times. Well, first of all, I still play very actively as a violinist. So I never stopped playing. For me, it's still a dualism, being conductor and being a violinist. I'm still both very much. Every year I have also nice challenges involving me playing, so it's a good balance. I'm really happy that we are able to do two concerts with an audience. In many places right now in the world, it's not possible to do concerts with audience. Here we can do it, and I'm very happy for that, and really looking forward and hoping for a lot of those who can come to the concert that they really will be there and enjoy this wonderful program.